Hello everyone, in this video I'm going over Azure Bastion. Hello everyone, my name is Travis and this is Seraltos. I was on a much needed vacation when Azure Bastion went into public preview and I'm a little bit late to the game on this video. But as I always like to say, the early bird may get the worm, but the second mouse gets the cheese. Before we dig in, please take a second to subscribe. It'll be more rewarding to me than this fish I caught. Let's start with what a bastion host is and why it's important. A bastion host is a secure, purpose-built server that sits between the public and internal network. In this case, it acts like a jump box, allowing secure connection to servers on an internal network. Azure Bastion is a purpose-built PaaS jump box that provides connectivity to servers in an Azure environment. If you're familiar with Windows Remote Desktop services, it's kind of like the web gateway, but with some extra cloud goodness. First, it's a purpose-built PaaS offering, secured and kept up-to-date by Microsoft. Users connect to the servers directly through the portal, no RDP or SSH client required. It offers multi-platform, multi-browser support with almost any HTML5 client. There's no need to give servers a public IP address for this to work, although the Bastion server does need a public IP. The Azure documentation provides a good diagram of how all this works. A user logs into the portal and from there they can access Azure Bastion. Azure Bastion is connected to your private network, providing access to servers on that network. Azure manages the network security groups for the Bastion. You can add a network security group to the server subnet, allowing RDP and SSH traffic only from the Bastion, but that's not required. Keep in mind that a Bastion is assigned to a VNet. If you have multiple VNets, you'll need multiple Bastions, one for each VNet. Let's look at prerequisites. There's a few things needed before you can deploy a Bastion service. You need a /27 or larger subnet named Azure Bastion Subnet. No NSGs or routes can be assigned to the subnet. In order to get to Azure Bastion, you have to use the aka.ms/bastionhost link to get to the portal. At the time of this recording, this is not available in even the regular preview portal. And you need an HTML5 client. The Azure Bastion has to reside in the same region as the VNet it's connected to. As of today, the only regions in preview are West US, East US, West Europe, South Central US, Australia East, and Japan East. You no longer need to register for the preview. You may find references to the Register Azure RM Preview feature on blogs, but you no longer need to do that. Okay, with that, let's hit the demo.
Buckle up, everyone. It's demo time. In this demo, I'm going to start out by adding the subnet for the Azure Bastion. After that, I'm going to create the Bastion, and then once that's done, I'm going to try to access it. Before I move on to that, when I first started preparing for this video, there were some requirements posted that you have to use the Register Azure RM Provider feature and Register Azure RM Resource Provider for the Microsoft network as a prerequisite for Azure Bastion. I don't see that in the documentation anymore, and I reached out to Microsoft. They indicated that that is no longer needed. So if you see any documentation out there that has that listed, evidently it's not required anymore for the Azure Bastion preview. Okay, let's move on to the Azure subnet. So if I go into virtual networking, and I'm going to go into my West VNet. My main VNet is in Central US. That's where I keep most of my servers. That's not in the preview at this point. So I'm going to use my other one, which is in West, and that is in the preview. The Azure Bastion has to be in the same region as the VNet. So I'll go under subnets, and I'm going to add a subnet. And it has to be a minimum of /27. I'll leave it as /24. And according to the documentation, it is required to have the name Azure Bastion Subnet. And no security groups or routing tables. That's another requirement according to the documentation. I'll leave service endpoints and subnet delegation as it is. And click OK. That should just take a second to deploy. And there it is. The next step, I'm going to create the Bastion. At the time of this recording, there's a couple of special requirements around creating the Bastion. It can't be done through the normal portal. It also can't be done through the typical preview portal. Microsoft gave a URL Let's just paste it in here, of aka.ms/bastionhost. And again, at the time of this recording, that is the required portal to use to set this up. So let's go there. And it looks like the normal preview, but I guess it's different. So I'm going to create a resource and I'll search for Bastion. And there it is, Bastion preview. So let's go to that. I'm going to create. I have a resource group already set up called Bastion Demo RG. We'll call it Bastion Demo. And I'm going to use West US, again, because that is where my virtual network is located. As you can see, it's in the West US, and I only have the option for the West VNet. So again, you don't see the VNet I have in Central US. And here you can see the subnet named Azure Bastion subnet is the only one available. And that one is not, the selected subnet is not supported. I'm going to leave the public IP address as default. As you can see, it only has static as an option. So I'm just going to review and create. I don't set up tags on my demos, although tags are quite important. Okay, let's create. And we'll give this some time to deploy, and I'll be back when it's done. All right, so that's complete. It took about 5 minutes, as you can see under the duration, to finish. So I guess the next step now is to see if it works. So the first thing I'm going to do is go over to Virtual Machines. And I've got the demo 1, which happens to be a Windows OS. So let's see if RDP works. I'll go into Connect, and you can see I have the option for RDP, SSH, and Bastion. So I'm going to keep it on Bastion. Now, before I do that, I'm just going to, real quick, I'm kind of curious. If I hop back to my regular portal, go to Virtual Machines, I'm going to do the same thing, demo 1. Connect. And yep, as I suspected. So not only do you need that specific portal to create the Bastion, you also have to use that to access the Bastion. That's fine. This is preview. It's not GA, so little quirks like that are expected. So let me log in. And I'll connect. Oh. Let me unblock my pop-ups. And try again. And look at that. So this is a freshly deployed OS. I just did it a few minutes ago. It may take a couple seconds to get up here, so I'll just pause. All right, so this is a new OS installed. It's the first time I logged in, so it took a couple minutes, but we're here. And as you can see, it works just like you'd expect. I've got a start menu, pretty straightforward. I'm not going to go into the OS. That's not what this is about. But there is one little handle here that's different that I just want to go over. Underneath it, there's two items. There's a text copy paste between the Bastion and the localhost, and then full screen. Let's hit this full screen first. As you'd expect, it goes into full screen. Okay, so that's full screen mode. So let's exit out of full screen. And there we have it. I'm going to close. Let me just log off. There we go. So that is RDP into a Windows server using Azure Bastion. Now that we have that done, let's go over to my virtual machines. We're going to go into demo 2, which is running Linux OS. And I'll click connect. I do have the set for password, not SSH key, but you can see there's different options here. SSH private key and SSH private key from a local file. So I can enter the private key here, or I can go to it, go to a path. Okay, that's it. So I'm in. Let me just take a look at the IP settings just to show it's working. As you can see, I only have one network card, and that only has a private IP. So as far as RDPing to this, the only option I have is that public route through the Bastion host. Let me log out. Oh, wrong command. There we go. And I'll close it again. Okay, so there it is. That is how you create the Azure Bastion subnet, create the Azure Bastion service in the Azure Bastion preview portal, and then use the Bastion to connect to both a Windows and a Linux OS using RDP and SSH. That's it for the demo.
Okay, one final item, pricing. At the time of this recording, the price is 0.095 cents US per hour plus transfer fees, the first 5 gigs per month being free. This is a special half-off price for the preview. I hope you found this helpful. Please take a second to subscribe and click the bell icon for notifications of new content. Thanks for watching.